Okay, so I'm going to show a video on converting hectares to acres. And this is dealing with two units that are in area units. So they're not linear, they're area. So the way I think might be helpful to think about this is if I've got an area, that's a square, and it is 35 hectares. All right? It's 35 hectares. Then, if I was to do that area equals 35 hectares, if I do the square root of 35, I will get a linear measurement here. But there's no linear measurement in a hectare, it's a square measurement already. So, what we need to do is convert these hectares into a unit that is something squared. And one of the base things you might want to memorize is that 1 hectare is equal to 10,000 meters squared. I know maybe you don't think you need to memorize any of this stuff, but that is something you need to memorize. 1 hectare equals 1,000 meters squared. A hectare is a square unit in metric. An acre is a square unit in imperial. So what we're going to have to do is use some conversion factors and convert this hectare or 35 hectares into acres by taking our hectare into meters squared. Then we can turn that into a linear unit. So just one side of this square in meters, which we'll be able to convert into feet. Which would be now we're going to imperial, and then from feet, we can square that unit to make it feet squared, and then from feet squared, we can get to our acres. Okay, so given a couple of things down here, and I believe we have that 1 foot equals 0.303048 meters. That's a given known relationship. And that 1 acre is equal to 43,560 square feet. Okay, now my 35 hectares. If 1 hectare is 1,000 meters squared, then 35 hectares would be 350,000 square meters. And that's just, I multiply this number, the 1, by 35. So we must multiply 10,000 by 35. So 35 hectares equals 350,000 meters squared. Okay, now that means that this 35 hectare square box has an area of 350,000 square meters. Well, if that's its area, area equals length times width, it's a square, so area equals the length squared. If we want the length, we need to square root 350,000. So length of our square is equal to the square root of 350,000. And you can go back with your calculator and check on how to do all of these things. But that number is 591, and I'm just going to use a whole bunch of decimal places because I don't want to do any rounding yet. I'm just sort of showing you what you would see on your calculator. All right. So if I square root my meters squared, that square roots the unit as well. So this is just now in meters. So this square has 591.60798 meters by 591.60798 meters. If I was to multiply those together, I would get the area of 350,000 meters squared. Okay, so this is a linear distance now, not a square one. Hopefully that makes sense. Now we can use these relationships to change it from meters to feet. So we want to go, once I'm in meters, this is changing to imperial now, meters to feet. And then we can square that number to get it feet squared and use this conversion to do feet squared to acres. That's what we're going to work on. All right, let's go in blue now. We're going to convert meters to feet. All right, now I like to use a ratio and proportion method for conversion. So on one side of my proportion, I always have the known relationship. So in terms of meters on top, and it doesn't matter which one you put on top, 0.3048 in meters is equal to, in feet down here, 1 foot, right? That's a ratio of meters to feet. Now on the other side of the equal sign, we want to have an equal relationship. So I want to put my meters, and here is going to be 591.60798. And when I do the cross multiply and divide, I will get 591 meters converted into feet. Turns out that x is equal to 1,940 feet. And again, we're just keeping all those decimal places for accuracy. We don't really need that many, but I'm not sure where you want me to round off, so it really doesn't matter. You just don't want to round to whole numbers all the way through, and then you'll have some error in your rounding. So keep the decimal places as you go. All right. There's our number, and now we want to convert that feet, this measurement in feet, to feet squared. So let's go pick another color to write in, and I can do that up here. It's going to get a little messy on the screen. So if I want to change my 1,940.971063 feet, if I square that, I will have my unit in feet squared. All right, so we'll convert this now to feet squared. So let's just square that. Okay. And when you square that number, you get 0.667. And this is now square feet. Okay, we're almost there, right? Now we have our square feet. We have a conversion factor for square feet, and I'll go with one more color here just to do that. And I'm going to do a very similar type of thing as we did there. I would like to have my feet squared on the numerator and my acre in the bottom. All right, so let's put the values there. 4,3560/1 is equal to, and our feet squared value, so that's this number. I won't write it again, but it goes right there. Will be equal to, once we cross multiply and divide, our number of acres. So hopefully you remember the cross multiply and divide. If I want to solve for this number right here, I multiply these two values together and divide by its diagonal. Okay, so I'm multiplying the 3,767,368 by 1, divide by 43,560. And when we do that, we get that this is 86.5 acres. Okay. I hope that's helpful. Remember, acre is a square unit. Put that into a linear unit squared first, because we want to take it to linear. And then convert that meters in linears to feet in imperial. Square that back to square. And then change square feet to acres. All right, these things over here, either given or you memorize, same with this one, in order to show all that work. All right, I hope that's helpful.